Directive Principle of State Policy, Part 4. In this part, unless the context otherwise requires, the state has the same meaning as in Part 3. 37. The provisions contained in this part shall not be enforceable by any court, but the principles therein laid down are nevertheless fundamental in the governance of the country, and it shall be the duty of the state to apply these principles in making laws. 38. 1. The state shall strive to promote the welfare of the people by securing and protecting as effectively as it may a social order in which justice, social, economic, and political shall inform all the institutions of the national life. 2. The state shall in particular strive to minimize the inequality in income and endeavor to eliminate inequalities in status, facilities, and opportunities, not only among individuals but also amongst group of peoples residing in different areas or engaged in different vocations. 39. The state shall in particular direct its policy towards securing that the citizens, men and women, equally have the right to an adequate means of livelihood, that the ownership and control of the material resources and the community are so distributed as best to subserve the common good, that the operation of the economic system does not result in the concentration of wealth and means of production to the common detriment, that there is equal pay for equal work for both men and women. E. The health and strength of workers, men and women, and the tender age of children are not abused, and that citizens are not forced by economic necessities to enter avocations unsuited to their age of strength, that children are given opportunities and facilities to develop in a healthy manner and in condition to of freedom and dignity, and that the childhood and young youth are protected against exploitation and against moral and material abandonment. 39a. State shall secure that the operation of the legal system promote justice on a basis of equal opportunity, and shall in particular provide free legal aid by suitable legislative or schemes or in any other way to ensure that opportunity for securing justice are not denied to any citizens by reason of economic or other disabilities. 40. The state shall take steps to organize village panchayats and endow there with such powers and authority as may be necessary to enable them to function as units of self-government. 41. The state shall, within the limits of its economic capacity and development, make effective provision for securing the right to work, to education, and to public assistance in case of employment, old age, sickness, and disablement, and in other cases of undeserved want. 42. The state shall make provision for securing just and humane conditions of work and for maternity relief. 43. The state shall endeavor to secure by suitable legislation or economic organization or in any other way to all working, agricultural, industrial, or otherwise work, a living wage, conditions of work ensuring a decent standard of life and full enjoyment of leisure and social and cultural opportunities, and in particular, the state shall endeavor to promote cottage industries on an individual or cooperation basis in rural areas. 43a. The state shall take steps by suitable legislations or in any other way to secure the participation of workers in the management or undertaking establishment or other organizations engaged in any industry. 44. The state shall endeavor to secure for the citizens a uniform civil code throughout the territory of India. 45. The state shall endeavor to promote within a period of 10 years from the commencement of this constitution for free and compulsory education for all children until they complete the age of 14 years. 46. The state shall promote with special care the educational and economic interest of the weaker sections of the people, and in particular of the scheduled caste and the scheduled tribes, and shall protect them from social justice and for all forms of exploitation. 47. The state shall regard the raising of the level of the nutrition and the standard of living of its people and the improvement of public health as among its primary duties, and in particular the state shall endeavor to bring about prohibition of the consumption except for medicinal purposes of intoxicating drinks and of drugs which are injurious to health. Article 47 DPSP. So that Bihar Sarkar abolish drinks in Bihar. 48. The state shall endeavor to organize agriculture and animal husbandry on modern and scientific lines and shall in particular take steps for preserving and improving the breeds and prohibition the slaughter of cows and calves and other milch and draught cattle. 48. The state shall endeavor to protect and improve the environment and to safeguard the forest and life of the country. 49. It shall be the obligation of the state to protect every monument or place or object or artistic or historic interest declared by or under law made by Parliament to be of national importance from spoliation, disfigurement, destruction, removal, disposal or export, or in case may be. 50. Article. The state shall take steps to separate the judiciary from the executive in the public service of the state. 51. The state shall endeavor to promote international peace and security, maintain just and honorable relation between nations, foster respect for international law and treaty, obligation in the dealings of organized people with one another, and increase settlement of international disputes by arbitration.